So as I mentioned before lunch that next we are going to have a session on cyber bullying and security. As in today's scenario in this COVID period, we are facing lots of problem while participating in virtual classes, while organizing virtual classes. So we try to have a small on this topic too, because we need to know what we have to do while we are attacking or while we are dealing with cyber safety. So Neha Sharma is with us. Neha is a faculty at that Daryaganj. So I would like to invite Neha. Are you with me?
Yes, ma'am, I'm with you. I'm able to hear your voice. Thank you so
okay.
much.
So I think we should start with the presentation.
Yeah, sure.
So the platform is all yours. Thank you.
Thank you so much, Anamika, ma'am. Very good morning to all of you once again. I'm Neha Sharma from Dad Daryaganj, and I'm a lecturer over here. So today's topic for the discussion would be cyber safety and cyber bullying. I hope my screen is visible.
Ma'am, your voice is very low.
Is it audible?
Yes, it's audible to me.
Yeah. Okay. My screen is also visible, Anamika, ma'am.
Yes,
can
yes,
you confirm?
Visible. Yes, yes.
Yeah.
Visible.
Thank you so much, ma'am. Okay. So, from this session only, this particular topic has been introduced in the as one of the general topic, that is cyber safety and cyber bullying. Now, talking about the current scenario, this particular topic has gained very much importance. Looking at the safety purpose while handling the all kinds of cyber devices, every kind of communication devices that we're using day by day. So this topic is the need of the hour, I must say, and we must be aware of how to protect ourselves from all such kinds of cyber crimes. So if you look at the current scenario, then we are seeing that we are using internet, computers, smartphones, and all other kinds of communication devices in our day-to-day life. And I won't be wrong if I say that we are spending much more time on such devices day by day. Aajkal ke jo youngsters hain, be it the teenagers, be it the adults one, they are actually posing this threat to everyone that they are spending too much time on computers, smartphones, etc. So what they are doing actually, they are not giving their importance to their health, but they are much more indulged in such communication devices. So if we are spending too much time on such devices, then it's our duty to see that since we are using various medias, social medias, then we must make sure that whatever daily activities we are doing, we must not ignore all such kinds of cyber crimes which are occurring day by day. You must have heard about this particular terminology, that is cyber crime, in many of the newspapers, in various kinds of shows, television shows, which make you aware of the such crimes which are occurring. This is a technology era, and so the crime has also been using technology. Criminals are using such technologies for the benefits of themselves, and they are putting your life at stake on different platforms.
Sorry for interruption, Neha ma'am, your voice is cracking a lot. Hello, Neha ma'am. Your voice is cracking as well as we're not able to listen to you, ma'am. Am I audible to others? Hello?
Yes,
Hello?
ma'am.
Okay, okay. So there must be a problem with the RP, I think. No, Neha ma'am, you are still not audible. No, still you're not audible. Is she audible to others? Hello? If anybody can confirm.
Hello? Now you can hear me?
Yes.
Okay.
Yes,
okay.
Neha ma'am.
Okay. Thank you so much for this technological glitch. So what I was talking about that this particular using technology for our own benefit is the need of the hour, and we are using for our own benefits, but we should be aware of the various kinds of threats which are associated with such kinds of technological devices. So cyber is a form which is related to which is a combination of different terminologies. That is, it incorporates your information technology, it incorporates your internet and the virtual reality. So whenever we call cyber terminology, whenever we hear this particular term, then it is a combining form which is related to the information technology, internet and the virtual reality. What exactly is cybercrime? Cybercrime is they are the crimes which are associated with the technology itself. So they are committed against the individual, they are committed against the companies or the institutions using the technological devices like computer, internet or the mobile technologies. अभी आजकल अगर हम देखते हैं तो हम बहुत सारे ऑडियोज में ये चीज सुनते हैं कि आपके पास एक फेक ईमेल आया जिसके अंदर दे सेड दैट यू हैव वॉन सम काइंड ऑफ लॉटरी एंड यू हैव टू गिव योर बैंक डिटेल्स टू देम सो दैट दे कैन सेंड द मनी और ट्रांसफर द मनी टू योर बैंक अकाउंट. जनरली जो यंगस्टर्स होते हैं एंड द ओल्ड पीपल दे गेट ट्रैप्ड इन सच काइंड ऑफ सिचुएशंस एंड दे गिव बैक देयर बैंक डिटेल्स. And due to this, they have to face real, very real problem that they have, their account has been emptied by such persons. And from where they are operating from this same city or from the different cities in India itself. So we have to be sure that whatever we are doing or whatever we are corresponding to someone, then we have to make sure that we are safe. We don't have to. आपके पास बैंक से भी SMS आते हैं. You have to do your KYC. KYC वाला जो scenario था, that was much prevalent during the COVID situation. जब Paytm की Paytm app के through KYC करवाने का बहुत ज़्यादा mandatory हो गया था. And many of the fraudsters, they were actually calling the customers that we can have your KYC done in a click. You have to just tell us your bank details and the card number, PIN number. So we have to make sure that we don't get trapped in such situations. So cyber criminals are using the platforms such as the social networking sites, email, phones, fake software, websites, etc. to attack a victim. Now, children can also be a victim of various kinds of cyber crimes, which we'll see in the next slide. So talking about the Indian scenario, India is standing nowhere behind in getting trapped in such things, such crimes. According to Crime in India 2016 report, which was published by NCRB, there has been increase in about 9.30% in the number of cyber crime, which has been reported under the IT Act 2000. In 2016, over the figures which has been reported in 2015. So the cases which were registered under the IT Act 2000 in 2016 was approximately 12,317. And these are the cases that has been actually filed. There are a number of cases jahan pe jo persons hote hain, jo ki is trap ke andar phas jate hain, they don't even report to such cases. So this number can be high enough. So what are the different major categories that are including in such kinds of cybercrime? Either their account gets hacked, be it the bank frauds or be it the email account or any social networking account. There is forgery through the computers. There are publication, transmission of obscene information in electronic form, that is pornography, and trust in the frauds, etc. So the term cybersecurity, when there's a cyber crime, there's a security also possible. So the term cybersecurity has been given to secure yourself from such kinds of cyber crimes. And it is a security offered through online services to protect the online information. Now, most of the participants are using social media sites. So you will be seeing that after every updation, there are such kinds of security innovations being done over the internet. And you have to make sure that you are protected well while using such social networking sites. It encompasses all kinds of security, like physical security, environmental regulation acts, and the compliance security. So we have to make sure that we are cyber secure while using technology. Now, what is the need of cyber security? Cybersecurity helps in securing the data from the threats such as data theft, which uses or misuses your information, personal information, be it on the social networking site or be it your bank details, etc. And it safeguards your viruses as well. That's the different we are facing now: virus, hackers, malware, password cracking, and Trojan horses. These are the five major security problems that we are facing day by day. And we have to make sure that we are well protected from such kinds of security problems. So we'll be taking this major security problems one by one. So virus, these are the programs which is loaded onto your computer without your knowledge and runs against your wish. I'll give you a simple example of this. Whenever you search any website, be it a shopping website or something like that, some pop-up windows will come. Give the permission for accessing your information or accessing your data, and in a hurry, majority of the persons just click OK. They just allow it, and through those particular sites, they transfer the one which is hosting the virus, that transfers the virus into your computer, and you exactly don't know when it has come to your computer. So what are the solutions? That you have to install security suite which protects your computer against such threats. You have to make sure that you don't click allow in such situations. Hackers, they are the persons who breaks into your computer, usually by gaining access to administrative controls. That you or the system or nothing has been hacked. आप लोगों ने बहुत सारी reports भी पढ़ी होंगी, आपके किसी known to में भी शायद ये चीज हुई होगी कि उनके सोशल मीडिया अकाउंट हैक हुए हैं, बैंक अकाउंट हैक हो गया है, या आजकल एक नया ट्रेंड चल गया है कि एक फेक अकाउंट बना लिया जाता है, जैसे कि मेरे नाम पे एक फेक अकाउंट बना लिया गया है और मेरे जितने भी उस सोशल मीडिया में जितने भी फ्रेंड्स हैं उनको एक मैसेज मैसेंजर के तौर पर, मैं फेसबुक का एग्जाम्पल दूंगी, मैसेंजर से मैसेज भेज के बोला जाता है कि दैट आई नीड मनी, तो मेरे ये बैंक अकाउंट डिटेल्स है तो यहाँ पे ट्रांसफर कर दो. एंड जो आपके जेन्युइनली फ्रेंड्स होते हैं वो कई बार क्या होता है, उनकी केयरलेसनेस समझ लीजिए या कुछ भी समझ लीजिए, दे ट्रांसफर द मनी टू दैट पर्टिकुलर अकाउंट विदाउट इवन कंफर्मिंग फ्रॉम योरसेल्फ. सो वी हैव टू मेक श्योर दैट आवर अकाउंट एवरीथिंग नीड्स सिक्योर. सो फॉर दैट यू हैव टू, इट समटाइम्स बिकम इम्पॉसिबल टू प्रिवेंट, बट इफेक्टिव सिक्योरिटी कंट्रोल्स लाइक स्ट्रॉन्ग पासवर्ड्स एंड यूज ऑफ फायरवॉल्स, इट कैन हेल्प यू इन प्रिवेंटिंग हैकिंग योर सोशल मीडिया अकाउंट्स और योर कंप्यूटर सिस्टम. Malware is a third kind of major issue that has been encountered. It comes from the word malicious software, so that's why it's named as malware. It is any software that infects and damages a computer system without the owner's knowledge or permission. Malware generally comes either through accessing different pornographic sites or certain kinds of gaming sites. Through that malware, there's an equal opportunity that malware can invade your computer system. So what you have to do, you have to download an anti-malware program, activate the network threats like protection firewalls, antiviruses. So your system, your mobile phone, in fact, there are certain software that are protecting your mobile devices as well. Initially, it was being launched for the computer system or the desktop or the laptop, but now it has some security software come for devices also. So your device should be it the laptop or be it your mobile phone, it has to be protected from such kinds of threats. Trojan horse is an email virus that usually comes through email IDs. and it invades your system and duplicates itself. It steals your personal information that has been saved onto your computer. So it's always advisable, and many of you must have received certain SMSs or some messages from the authority itself, that don't read messages or don't respond to emails that has been sent from someone who you don't know. So you have to make sure that your system remains safe, and it's in your hands to make it possible. Password cracking. They are the attacks by the hackers to determine the password or find passwords to different protected electronic areas and social networking sites. हम जनरली हमें देखते हैं कि हमारे को फ्री वाईफाई मिल रहा है पूरी दिल्ली के अंदर. अगर हम बात करें जैसे कि राजीव चौक के मेट्रो स्टेशन पे है, इट गिव यू एक्सेस टू द फ्री वाईफाई सिस्टम. बट जब आप उस फ्री वाईफाई को एक्सेस करते हैं, देन योर मोबाइल डिवाइस इज इक्वली वल्नरेबल टू गेट हैक्ड बाय एनी ऑफ द हैकर्स बिकॉज इट इज नॉट पासवर्ड प्रोटेक्टेड. प्लस देयर इज एन प्रॉपर situation can happen that the virus or the malware can invade your system. So you have to make sure that whatever you are accessing, use strong password. Never use the same password for two different sites. Like for if you have two Gmail IDs, or if you have one Gmail ID and one social networking account, don't use the same password. Hum apni ease ke liye same password kar lete ki kaun itne password yaad rakhega, but it is better that you use different passwords for different sites. So that everyone cannot simply judge it, and make the password as strong as possible, because there are some passwords that are easy to guess. Some make their password as their date of birth or their mobile number. So make sure that you use the passwords that are strong, and that uses different special characters as well in between. That is not easy to guess. The cyber day by day are spoofing malicious file applications that we have already gone through. Cyber bullying, identity theft, job frauds, and banking fraud. So now I'll be dealing with one of the particular cyber threat, that is cyber bullying. We are teacher. We are seeing in day to day life that we are dealing with such students who are either being cyber bullied or who are cyber bullying someone else. So what exactly is cyberbullying? So cyberbullying is not unlike the normal bullying jo pehle ke time pe hua karta tha, ki lunch boxes ke liye ya pocket money ke liye kisi ko threat karna. Jo zyada powerful bacche hote the wo chote bachchon ko apne juniors ko threat kiya karte the, either for the lunch boxes or for the money. Ye jo bullying hai, cyberbullying jo hai, wo 21st century mein exist nahi karti hai, kyunki technology has a great advancement. So the cyber bullies are hiding behind their computer screens to torment their targets. They are accessing this thing. They are making the person they put them in such a vulnerable situation that the students or the teenagers, they fail to tell someone about that. So like the technology has advancement, so do the bullies have advancement themselves? So cyberbullying is a combination of two words, that is cyber and bully. Simple bullying, if you talk about, it is understood as an aggressive and intentional act or behavior which is carried out either by an individual or a group of individuals who repeatedly and over a time they do some intentional act or behavior, it's something like that, and the person who is getting bullied cannot defend easily himself or herself. And cyberbullying is used to describe the bullying that is taking place on the internet. So in a simple bullying, if we look at the differences between the two, then cyberbullying is totally different from the traditional bullying. The victims often don't know who the bully is because it is occurring over the internet, be it through some fake accounts or something like that, or why they are being targeted. Sometimes the victim don't get this idea as well. It can be done from a distant place, and the bully doesn't have to see the person's response. That means in face-to-face, that is the traditional bullying, one can see what the other person is feeling about. But in cyberbullying, the person who is bullying someone is not at all concerned whatever the bully, the person or the victim is feeling about. He just wants to show his or her power. Many adults don't have the technical skills to monitor or respond, and they just get into this particular trap. So if we talk about the comparison between the cyberbullying and the bullying, usually face-to-face mode, while cyberbullying, it can occur 24/7. So it can be 365 days a week, 365 a year. So you cannot predict that whenever a person is getting cyberbullied. In simple traditional bullying, a person who is getting bullied can find a safe space or escape. But it is not possible in case of cyberbullying. There is no safe space available. It is hard to escape. The bullying is limited to the onlookers, that the person walking around, they are the public audience that are looking that bullying is occurring. But cyberbullying can be shared by a wide audience. They can share your any kind of video, any kind of social media sites, and it can go viral in a matter of seconds. In the traditional bully, the bully can be identified, while in cyberbullying, the bully can be anonymous. In traditional bullying, the bully can see the facial expressions and body reaction of the target and the onlookers, while it is harder to empathize with the target in case of cyber bullying. So why it is so important to know about the into all age groups are being cyberbullied. And if we talk about the statistics, then one out of every three children has been a victim of cyberbullying. Nearly half of the suicide among the 10 to 14 years of age, which is the teenage period, they are due to bullying, that they are being so much traumatized that they commit suicide. Cyberbullying typically starts at the age of 9 years of age and usually ends after 14 years of age. And after 14, if the person is not able to share his particular problem with anyone, then that person or that victim can fall into cyber harassment or any kind of sexual harassment. Sometimes pornographic pictures are being also spread over, it goes viral. So we have to make sure that our children who are working on the computer, right now they are working on the online mode, they are indulged in various kinds of online gaming apps. So we have to make sure that they are not being cyber bullied at any kind of situation. And nor our children are bullying someone. You have to make sure. 33% of the victims had been subjected to online threats. After that, being bullied over a particular time period, they are being harassed over the internet to give money or something like that. 95% of the teens in cyberbullying do nothing about it. They just simply try to ignore it or face it, and they just go. Person will stop bullying a particular victim. This is not the situation. 50% of the teens who are the victims of cyberbullying do not tell their parents. But they hesitate that if they tell their parents might fetch their accounts and don't allow them to access those accounts or to sit on the internet. So for that particular reason, they don't tell their parents and get cyberbullied. So this is other side of the statistics which are being shared with you. It is according to NCERB data. So there are two kinds of cyberbullying. One is the direct attack, where the messages are sent directly to the victim, either through social media apps, through email, or through text messages, anything over the internet. While in cyberbullying, there is another kind of cyberbullying, which is by proxy. That is using someone else to cyberbully a victim. That means the bully is not directly involved here. He or she is targeting someone else to a third person to cyberbully a victim. This proxy may know that they are cyberbullying someone, or they may not know. So these are the two categories of cyberbullying. So what are the different forms of cyberbullying? If we talk about the cyberbullying, we generally see that means passing comments is simply that cyberbullying. But there are different forms of cyberbullying that are existing in nature, like exclusion. Rejecting a person from the group is a kind of cyberbullying, because you humiliate that person over his or her characteristics and you exclude that person from the group. That is a form of cyberbullying. Online harassment, that is insulting on the net, ग्रीफिंग दैट इज हरासिंग ऑन द साइबर गेम। जो भी आजकल ऑनलाइन गेमिंग चल रही है, अगर बच्चे खेलते हैं ऑनलाइन गेमिंग तो व्हाट एक्चुअली दैट द लैंग्वेज दे आर यूजिंग इज क्वाइट ऑफुल। Bad languages, they are using bad languages, and that is a form of the cyberbullying itself. Flaming, that is sending vulgar messages to someone over the internet. Cyber stalking, that is continual threatening and sending of rude messages. That means you are stalking someone through cybernet. Masquerade, that is bully creates a fake identity to harass someone else. Impersonation, that is breaking into someone's account to send messages. That is, you create a duplicate account and you send that particular person some kind of obscene languages or some kind of obscene. Trolling, that is using abusive commands on the website. A bully, either due to anger, due to frustration, and just for the entertainment person or to get attention. Or some persons are even power hungry, so for that purpose they do cyberbully someone. That is who wants attention from the peers, who wants the reaction, who wants to control someone with fear. There are certain person who has been a retaliating victim who was cyberbullied in the past, and he or she seeks revenge on the bullies, so they instead get indulged in cyberbullying. They can be a mean person who bullies someone for entertainment or to become popular, to gain popularity, something like that. And there are certain inadvertent cyberbully, the one who uses internet carelessly and does not intentionally hurt others, and he may not realize that he is cyberbullying actually. What are the effects of the cyberbullying? The person who is getting cyberbullied, they have their feelings hurt, they fall into sadness, anxiety, depression. And talking about the particular effects, that can lead to sometimes suicidal cases as well, because the person is so much traumatized, he or she is going under so much stress that the person can, who's getting the cyberbullied, can commit suicide. The effects of cyberbullying is quite shocking, that it is permanent. The insults or the comments or images can be preserved by the person who was bullied, and it prevail throughout his or her lifetime. The audience size plays an important role, because if any kind of such things goes viral, then the person is not able to get cope up with such situation, and he faces humiliation each and every day. If he saw that many young people are friends who were cyber bully, either through the school or the other person connection, and they are increasing the potential for embarrassment and humiliation. And the speed by which such harmful messages reach to the larger audience, it is one of the after effects of cyberbullying. So what are the warning signs that if a person is a victim, so how would you identify that person is being cyberbullied? If he or she unexpectedly stop using computer or cell phone, feel quite uncomfortable while using such devices, he or she is nervous or jumpy when any kind of email appears, uneasy about going to school or doesn't want to go to school, appears to be angry over small issues, small talks, he or she bursts himself or herself, like those things, and about discussion about what they are doing on computer whenever their parents ask or whenever their friends ask, they try to avoid such situations. Becomes abnormally withdrawn, and loss of friends is one of the warning signs of the person who is being. Now, what are the prevention of getting cyberbullied? Never accept the friend request from an unknown person. If we are using social media websites, हमारे को आजकल ट्रेंड चल रहा है कि जितने नंबर ऑफ फ्रेंड्स ज्यादा होंगे हमारे सोशल नेटवर्किंग साइट पे, यानी कि हम उतने पॉपुलर हैं. But never accept friend request from an unknown person. There is a setting over the internet, over the Facebook, that anyone can send you a friend request. Or you can by default uncheck that thing, and only a known person can send you the friend request, and you can accept that. Do not share your personal information on social media. Generally, हम क्या करते हैं, अगर हम कहीं बाहर भी जा रहे हैं, आजकल के बच्चों के अंदर और adults के अंदर ये चीज देखने को मिल रही है, कहीं पे भी टूर पे जा रहे हैं तो वहाँ पे अपने आपको टैग करके हम बताएंगे कि हम वहाँ पे हैं, And the person who is keeping a watch on your home, he gets to know that you are not at home and certain kinds of thefts can occur at your place. So do not share your personal information or your personal things over the internet. Do not take unnecessary software or application from an unknown person, because to either be through online gaming or something like that, you have to avoid such situations, because malware or Trojan virus can enter your system and it can access your personal information, like your bank details, etc. If you are offended by reading a friend or unknown person's post, do not be aggressive. If you want to post certain comments, be polite, be gentle towards that person, because that person may get agitated and he or she can start cyberbullying the person. From my side, so at the end, I would say that you have to remain safe. For that, only connect with your friends. Think before what you post. Don't post such post. Don't post such images or something like that that can agitate someone. Be kind to others. Don't share a password and prepare a strong password for all your accounts. Keep your privacy settings activated and don't be hurtful towards others. So that's all from my side. I hope that I made you clear what is cyber safety and how we can be safe over the internet. Over to you, Anamika ma'am.
Thank you so much, Neha. And now I would ask all participants if they have faced any kind of such bullying while tackling any technological devices or any of the Facebook account or any social media. Because such topics have been taken for the student, you need to translate the same to the students, because they are, as Neha ma'am said, that having too many friends on Facebook, we have a status symbol that we have so many friends on Facebook. But this may get some kind of problem to the child as well. And if it's a girl child, then definitely some mischiefs are getting trapped due to all these things. So if you have any sharing from the side of the participants, you can share your experiences while handling social media. Yes,
I would like to say one thing to all the parents. Some of the participants, I suppose that they are parents as well, or otherwise they will be having some youngsters as well in their home. So be sure that what your child is actually watching or doing on the internet, just keep a close watch on that. Don't intervene whatever they are doing, but do keep a watch that you should be aware that what exactly they are accessing, because during the teenage time, they usually fall into pornographic sites, and you have to make sure that they don't access such sites, because maximum of the virus are actually being possible to access into your computer. So make sure what your child is doing.
Yes, ma'am. And I think it's a privilege to have virtual mode this time, because we were very much disconnected from social media and virtual mode. So we can take it as a blessing that now we are very much closer and we are in a very much good touch with virtual mode. So as Neha ma'am said, that we have some setting in the social media panels. So we have to check those settings as well, because the students or child doesn't hardly know all these facts. So you have to keep a view what your child is doing, what students are doing in the classroom, because many of the students are also carrying smartphone in the schools. So the reason may be they have to attend some classes, or there may be some other reasons, but you have to keep a gauge at them as well, that what they are watching, what link they are sharing, and what in which group they have been added. So we have to keep an eye on all those child as well, because there is a bad company on social media too. As in earlier times, we had some bad guys, so we were supposed to tag them as bad company. But in the social media as well, we have a bad company. So we have to keep all this in mind. So any of the participants want any sharing? I wish you share something, your experiences on social media. Am I audible to all? Am I audible? Hello?
Ma'am, you are audible.
To the participants? Yes, Swati ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
Do you have any sharing?
Have you seen someone being cyberbullied, or have you seen someone who has been cyberbullied in front of you, and have you done something for them? Can anyone share such incidents? or have you received certain emails which that you have won some lottery or something like that?
You may have some bad experiences as well as good experiences on social media. So we want to have those experiences with you. Yes.
Yes, I sometimes receive, I mean sometimes, not these days, that I have won lottery, I have so much, that they will put this amount in my account, so they need some account summary. But I used to ignore these things earlier. I used to receive them on my phone through SMS, now through email, but nothing these days because of the settings that I have used, I'm using these days now.
Yeah, so that means you have access to the privacy settings, you have activated those search settings, and it's good that you block search the sender's email. You can block that particular thing, you can block the receiving such emails from such sites as well.
Yes, and that is available for social networking sites also, like, and yes, social apps also, like Twitter and Telegram and WhatsApp, that we are dependent upon these days. So we should have take a look on the privacy privacy settings also, and yes, should educate our kids, because we are relying on these modes for education purposes. So they are very young and adolescents, because 9 to 12 are very vulnerable, is very vulnerable age, because they are adolescent, they fall into the category of adolescents, and they want to experiment everything. So we should educate them regarding the privacy settings, that you can do these things before before committing to anyone else. I mean, before sending any personal information to anyone else.
Yeah, thank you, Swati. And I would also request every participant who is having a certain kind of social media account. I would request when to YouTube right.
Yes, Vinod sir, you want to say something?
I would request to just check on your privacy settings that over the social media apps that you are using, be it Facebook, be it Twitter, be it Instagram, just see and have a look on your privacy settings. And in Facebook as well, you can block your DP, that is a digital photograph, that one can have a screenshot of that. And in fact, they cannot share your particular personal photos over the internet. So you have that particular setting as well in the Facebook.
Yes, yes. Even I was trying to say that on Facebook, you can have this facility of safeguard. You can save your profile photo. Nobody can take a screenshot of that photograph. And one more thing, that due to all these social media contact, the child is having mental issues. Mental health ka itna problem aajkal aa raha hai. So for in that case also, we need to see ki what settings are there, so, and how to deal with all these things, because aajkal itne games hain, jaise we have small kids at home and they don't have anything to spend time with, so they play games on mobile phones, aur mobile phones ka itna pressure hota hai ki they hardly sleep, unko ye rehta hai ki koi agla level kaise cross hoga, at what level I will reach, koi cousin mera pehle level na cross kar le, so all these things are causing stress on the mental health of the child. So आपको ये भी बच्चों को गाइड करना है कि डोंट रिलाय ऑन दीज डिवाइसेस टू मच, टेक इट ओनली एज इफ इट इज रिक्वायर्ड, क्योंकि पूरे टाइम हम कहते हैं हम इस पर रिलाय हो गए, बट वी हैव टू डिसाइड कि हमें किस टाइम इन चीजों को यूज करना है, किस टाइम हमें इनको यूज नहीं करना है. वी हैव टू टीच देम टू से नो टू दीज डिवाइसेस टू, राइट?
यस, राइट, वेरी ट्रू मैम.
हम कहते हैं हर चीज इस चीज के ऊपर डिपेंड करते हैं, बट वी हैव टू से नो, क्योंकि बच्चों के आई साइट भी वीक हो रहा है, मेंटल हेल्थ भी डिस्टर्ब हो रहा है. सो वी हैव टू मेक अ टाइम टेबल ऑफ दिस टू, दैट व्हेन यू हैव टू यूज दिस डिवाइस, व्हेन यू हैव टू यूज दिस एंड दैट. सो एज अ पेरेंट आई मस्ट, आई एम वेरी मच कंसर्न विद ऑल दिस थिंग्स, बिकॉज आई एम ऑल्सो अ मदर ऑफ टू किड्स. सो आई एम वेरी मच कंसर्न विद दिस कि बच्चों को एटलीस्ट नो कहना भी हम सिखाएं कि नहीं आपको ये यूज करना है, कब आपको यूज करना है. सो दिस इज माई पॉइंट ऑफ व्यू इन दिस रिगार्ड. एनी अदर शेयरिंग ऑफ द पेरेंट से or participants, then we'll close the session for 10 minutes. If any of the mothers are too much concerned.
Can I share? I am not the mother, I am not a parent. I want to share that there was a game actually. In future, yes.
Yes.
I have to share that not only apps and websites, but there are online games also. I think PUBG or and these kinds of games should be banned, or our kids should be educated towards them. And there was a game, I think Dolphin, if I remember, if I'm guessing
yes,
right.
Ma'am. Yes, ma'am. So, you're guessing it right.
So these things.
Blue Whale.
Hello.